Good morning. This is Sunday, January the 1st, 2023, and it's about 9:15 in the morning. 56 degrees, I think. Nice morning, a little damp. And you can see my Gerber daisies did not survive, even though I covered them. I had cardboard box over them, but maybe they'll come back from the ground. Pansies did okay. Larry's been working. He's going to put the pork loin in to marinate while we're gone. This is Sunday morning, and we're getting ready to start the year off by going to church. Sunday school. Well, there might not be any church, just Sunday school, because we're looking for a new pastor or other one moved to the upstate.
I hope everybody had a happy ending of the year, but this, we're looking forward to starting another good year. And with me and my beautiful wife, and we just hope that everybody out there stays safe and has a lot of good health for this year, this coming year. And the Lord has surely blessed us this last year, and I'm sure He's going to do it again this year.
I appreciate it.
I'm here with Larry. We brought his scrap that Steffi gave him.
How you doing?
Hey, pretty good.
I got
this is the yard.
Down the bottom. When I get to it, I'll know where it's at.
Yes, sir.
And a little piece of steel. I got a bucket full of small stuff.
I'm getting it unloaded. There he got weighed. Now he's out picking up his money. We're here at Steffi's and got another load of scrap. They had this all loaded for us. There's a cook stove and a freezer and looks like a piece of a car, a motor, and then we got all this old fence. So we're going back to the scrap yard. We're just here waiting in line to unload our second load.
Good thing you got that machine.
Well, then, there goes the stove. Goes the freezer.
Yes.
It's the motor.
You want me to roll it off the trailer?
There you got it. There's the culprit. There's the one that did it. Well, this is the inside of the cabana, and George likes to climb up the sides and get up here on top of the ceiling and lay. He just loves it up there. But I think today he kind of came down through it. He ripped it all loose. I started stapling it back up, but it's loose from his weight. He might be up to 8 pounds. I don't know. But I don't know what we're going to do. We'll staple it back and see if it holds.
It ain't going to hold.
Probably won't hold. We'll have to think of some way to fix it.
Cross pieces every so far apart would help.
He's out here when we're not, but he likes to get up there. We got it stapled back up. Hopefully it'll stay. I don't know how long. Didn't try and do it all pretty like we did before with the strips. They put in a bunch of staples because it may come down again. Larry's sitting here in the golf cart scrapping. He's taken something apart.
Game Boy or something.
Just getting parts out of it.
Well, the Christmas tree is down and back up in the attic. And I got the ornaments pretty much boxed up to go back up in. We had so many things to do today, it's been kind of slow going. This is Wednesday morning, and I thought I had everything put away. Closed the attic, swept it, everything done. Then I came in here in the living room, and there's still Merry Christmas right here. This is Wednesday, the 4th of January, and we're here at the doctor's for Larry's follow-up visit, and it's just pouring rain. There, just stop for a second. There goes somebody running. Maybe we better go right now. This is better than it was. Well, Larry got a good report from the doctor. He's okay. And so he's going to IGA. They have like a cafeteria where he can get his lunch. I can't have anything but clear liquids today. It's 6:46 and 60 degrees. And we're on our way to the local hospital for my colonoscopy. I'm glad that the prep for it is all over. That's always the worst part. Here I am, waiting for my colonoscopy. The doctor's been in and I'm all prepped and ready. I just got my IV, so won't be long. They'll come and get me, and then it'll take about a half an hour, and then another half hour in recovery, and then I'll go home. No, then I'll go eat.
Yeah, we'll go to the Waffle House, get a big breakfast.
Even though you're not supposed to.
Yeah.
I'm all done with my colonoscopy. Everything went well, no problems. And we just had breakfast at IHOP. So, good morning.
Well, the men came while I was at the hospital and worked on our driveway some more. Yesterday they scraped all the grass and everything away from it and power washed it. And now they've filled all the holes in, and then they oversprayed it with some kind of coating. So, make it last longer. Looks better.
Smells like Varsol and paint.
Well, we had a lot of little potatoes that were sprouted, so Larry's been out here this afternoon replanting. He's got it fertilized and dug up. Got them all down in there. Got them all replanted.
Come on, Chickie.
Laverne and Shirley got out. Yeah, they got out. They might have, you think it went up on the tree and topped over? All right, got some corn. We got some corn he's throwing out. It's Laverne and Shirley.
Chick,
chick. Come on, chick, chick. Chick, chick,
chick. I guess I ought to get the net. I guess you want me to get it?
I guess.
We got to figure out how they got over there yet. He's back where it belongs. Shame on you. He's gonna run up and be with the other one. She'd like to fly back over here.
But they didn't fly, they threw the fences down.
Larry caught the other one with the net too. He kept running along the fence. And now they're both back safe in the pen. If it had gone off into the woods, all kinds of critters could have got it. We got them locked in here for now, till we figure out where they got out, how to fix it. This is Saturday, the 7th of January, and I thought I'd give you an update on George. He had his first visit to the vet yesterday. He got an exam and a checkup. Got all of his shots, got a microchip, and he got neutered.
Poor boy. Come on.
So, he's confined out here to the cabana for a few days.
He doesn't like it.
He doesn't. He wants to get out and run, and he's not supposed to. And he spent last night in the bathroom. Back again, that was okay. But then today I came out and swept out here and brought all my stuff back out so he can be locked up here and still see what's going on. He is so hard to get in and out of here though without him running out the door. I have to be real careful. And earlier I put the harness and leash on him and we went back to see the chickens. But he's very friendly and loving now. He goes back to the vet again in 3 weeks to get a follow-up shot. But he did real good yesterday. I just carried him out on my lap and held him while Larry drove. And he was even good in the vet's office.
Oh, you're tickling. Tickling my neck. Hey, George. George.
Ah, he likes you.
You tickle. George, you tickle. You tickle. You tickle. Yes. You tickle.
Let me show her and lick you on the cheek.
You tickle. I don't want to kiss. I don't kiss cats.
Larry planted potatoes all down through here. It's kind of a above ground mulch. And they're just red potatoes and we like to eat them. Hopefully they'll grow and it won't be so cold. This flowering quince blooms every January, it seems to. Not a lot, but it blooms and it's nice to have something blooming in January.
Goes right up until about May or so.
Mm-hmm. It stay hangs on there a long time. Larry scrapped this little car, toy car. That's all plastic, but he got the tires and everything else out of it.
The battery and the axle.
Battery, axle.
A lot of metal.
So that's what he's been doing this afternoon. Well, this is Monday the 9th of January, and came back up here to see Larry's arrhythmia doctor. And we saw his assistant, and he's doing just great. Don't have to come back till August. No episodes or anything to report, so we're happy about that. George is out in the cabana, and he's sitting on the shelf that Larry and I put up for him today. It just puts him up a little higher place to roost. He's doing so well, we probably let him out to run around. We took him back to see the chickens again this evening and this morning. So he's not just shut up in there all the time. This is Tuesday, January the 10th, and I'm here at Betty's. I think we're going to see about getting the tire switched on her car. This is Friday the 13th, and this is my son David. He's been helping me this morning.
Hello.
I bought a new external drive, and then he did whatever he did to get it working on my Mac, because I'm just not very computer literate, and he is. So after he got that working, my external drive, he went ahead and did whatever else needed done and updated things. So, thank you, David.
You're welcome.
Nice to hear you speak. I like FaceTime. Okay. We got this dead pine tree here where the tops broke out of it. Larry's going to try and pull it over with the truck. He's got a rope up there on it that he's going to hook onto and pull. We'll see how strong it is. I got George locked here in the cabana so nothing happens to him. We're planning on putting fencing off this area again for the chickens. Tying the rope to the truck. We'll see what happens. He's going to take this tree down because he doesn't want it falling on the building or anything. Here we go. We'll see if something breaks on the rope first. He said the tree is rotted. Well, he got it, some of it. There, he'll cut the rest of it with the chainsaw.
That's good. I'd rather get it down now.
Yeah. Okay, gonna go let George loose. Now you can see how rotted it is. Now see where it broke. Time to take it down. This is still Friday morning and we planted some seeds. We got four little squares of broccoli and we got three of Rutgers tomatoes. And we got three of Bella Rosa tomatoes. And the cabbage is up and growing. And George still has decided he likes to ride on the golf cart with Larry. So he'll ride up there or on his lap or on the floor. But he likes it. Guess he's replaced the chickens because chickens can't get to it anymore. We caught another wild cat in the trap yesterday, and I never got a chance to film it. But we took it to town with us, and we met one of our friends, and he took it. So we found a home for that one. Now he's brought the trap back to us today. Yeah, we're here at Tammy and Michael's property. And they had a tree that cut that for us, the firewood. I found a warm place to stand, but they got their dogs and the camper here, so they're all set for the weekend. They're over there with the tractor of bush hogging. This is how much firewood we got this morning. Every bit helps. It'll put off a lot of heat. This is Saturday evening and it's supposed to be 27 degrees tonight. So we've got the wood rack really full. That'll be nice for the next few days. This is January the 15th, Sunday, so we're here for Sunday school and church. Wednesday night, we elected a search committee to look for a new pastor. Well, this is Sunday evening, and the sun's already gone down. It's the 15th, so I'm going to end my video. Had a nice afternoon. It warmed up some, and I had a nice nap, and then Bonnie came by, and we went for a walk a couple miles. And now it's going to be 27 degrees tonight. In a little bit, I'm going to take George in the house and lock him in the bathroom for the night. It's supposed to be warmer tomorrow, but 27 again tonight, so he'll stay in the bathroom and go out in the morning as soon as he quits attacking my foot. I haven't fed him, so I'm sure he'll come when he's called. Well, I hope you all had a good 2 weeks. I'm glad Larry's feeling better and not in the hospital anymore. Good night. God bless.